بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. أما بعد، رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. All praises and gratitude are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our provider, sustainer, the king of this world and the hereafter, inshallah ta'ala. Again, my sincere apology to our visitors, inshallah ta'ala. We are not here to hijack your beautiful time, inshallah ta'ala. But just as the continuation of inshallah ta'ala of our regular halqa, inshallah ta'ala, the jama'at, they always come here inshallah, most of them in area Minneapolis and Minnesota. They know that Saturday we always have inshallah ta'ala, and we are so delighted to have you here, subhanallah, to help us out as much as we struggle inshallah ta'ala. We have youngsters who always come here inshallah ta'ala. Amazingly, I myself and the masjid committee, we designed it. No matter how small they are, even if they come two of them, we still give them madrasa, subhanAllah. We do not undermine the number they are. InshaAllah ta'ala, man dalla ala khayrin kafa'ilihi, inshaAllah ta'ala. Bi'idhnillah, we almost coming to the end of the kitab, mashaAllah ta'ala. Tonight we have the 34th hadith of our halqa, alhamdulillah. And we didn't miss even one night, alhamdulillah. Bi'awnihi wa nusratihi, subhanAllah azza wa jal. And the beginning of the halqa, the ayah that I mentioned, I would like to remind, alhamdulillah, the students and those who come to the halqa. The main importance of coming to the halqa is that it has so many benefits. La yazalu al-mar'u fi salatin ma kanat salatu tahbisu. The person will be regarded as someone who is in salah, as long as the salah is the reason why that he's sitting in the majlis, subhanallah. Hada fadlullah. It's hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And apart from the dhikr that we're making, our efforts very little. One hadith or two hadith in a week. But indallahi is a big thing, subhanallah, azza wa jal. Indallahi is a big thing, subhanallah. Fudayl ibn Iyad, subhanallah, a great sahabi, subhanallah, azza wa jal. Kana ma kana fil jahiliyyah. In jahiliyyah he was whatever he was. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some time of his life, he was even a highway robbery. For some reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring him to the right path. And the ulama say, the reason why he became a ta'ib, one day he was in his hujra, in his room, and the neighbor next to him was reading the Quran. And this ayah came to his ear, subhanallah, he heard this ayah from the neighbor. أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ. Subhanallah. He only heard that ayah from the neighbor. And he said, حَقًّا لِلَّهِ يَا رَبِّي إِنِّي تَائِبٌ إِلَيْكِ. You might just come to the masjid for some other reason, but one hadith that might ignite your heart like that and make you transformation of your entire life, subhanAllah Azza wa Jal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us a lot. And inshaAllah ta'ala, I will encourage the youngsters, inshaAllah ta'ala, never give up on coming to the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Musa alayhi salam asked in this ayah, رَبِّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي in Surah Taha. He asked about 6-7 requests in one time. رَبِّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي وَيَسْرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَحْلُلْ عُقْدَةً مِنْ لِسَانِي يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي وَاجْعَلْ لِي وَزِيرًا مِنْ أَهْلِي هَارُونَ أَخِي أُجْدُدْ بِهِ أَزْرِي وَأَشْرِكُ فِي أَمْرِي. Subhanallah. That's it. What was the conclusion? كَيْ نُسَبِّحَكَ كَثِيرًا. Subhanallah. That's all. The reason, oh Allah, I'm asking you all these 8 requests, I can't remember you more. وَنَذْكُرَكَ كَثِيرًا. That's all, subhanallah. No any other reason. He did not even say, oh Allah, help me with Fir'aun. He did not say. That is not his major concern. It is not. But remembrance of Allah and remembering Allah and making tilkira to Allah, it is his main objective, subhanallah, azza wa jal. So we play in our role in a small capacity. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not write us as a qafilin, those who are neglectful, absent-minded from the conscience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عن أبي سعيد القدري رضي الله عنه. سعيد القدري, he narrated this hadith. And the title of the hadith is Fada'il wa Adab al-Islamiyyah, the virtue of the good manners Islamically. The good manners Islamically. That's what the hadith encourages. The title of the hadith, this hadith, it has two amazing comprehensive that been narrated from the hadith. One is that Islam encourages generosity. Rasulullah kan ajwad an-nas. He was the most generous person on the planet Earth. Nobody is more generous than Rasulullah. Then, as much as the Islam encourages you to be generous and give something from your pocket, fi sabilillah, to the sadaqah, to the zakah, to the masajid, to whatever, to the travelers, to the masakeen, to the yatim. In the same time, Islam stresses to be self-sufficient. Ajib. Self-sufficient. Even if you are in need. Unless it is the breaking point, Islam wants you to be self-sufficient, subhanAllah. And to be self-sufficient, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offered a lot of reward, subhanAllah. And this hadith will show some of that from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sa'id al-Qudri, he says, أن الناس من الأنصار some people of Ansar, you know them Ansar, subhanAllah عز وجل, Allahu Akbar كبيرا. سألوا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فأعطاهم ثم سألوا فأعطاهم ثم سألوه فأعطاهم حتى نفذ ما عنده فقال ما يكون عندي من خير فلن أدخر عنكم ومن يستعفف يعفه الله ومن يستغني يغنيه الله ومن يتبسر يسبره الله وما أعطي أحد عطاء خيرا وأوسع من الصبر سبحان الله عز وجل. Look at that. This Sahabi, he said, some people from the Ansar, they come to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking some kind of wealth. Because Rasulullah, Malul Muslimin, he was in charge when he was alive. Then they came and asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَسَأَلُوهُ فَأَعْطَاهُمْ He gave them, subhanAllah azza wa jal. ثُمَّ سَأَلُوهُ فَأَعْطَاهُمْ And they even asking one more time and he gave them. ثُمَّ سَأَلُوهُ فَأَعْطَاهُمْ He keep on giving them, subhanAllah Azza wa Jal. حَتَّى نَفِذَ مَا عِنْدَهُ Until everything that he had is finished, subhanAllah. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, and talked to them, he said, مَا يَكُونُ عِنْدِي مِنْ خَيْرٍ There will not be mal or wealth with me, or nearby me, or comes to me. The word khair sometimes can be used as a mal. لدى المحدثين والعربية كذا الخير in this hadith mal is the wealth. He says there's no wealth that will be with me. فَلَنْ أَدَّقِرُهُ عَنْكُمْ I will not hide away from you and I am not going to keep away from you. No. Whatever wealth that I get, I will not postpone for some other reason. I'm not going to be reserve it for some other people. Whatever I have, definitely I will give it to you, subhanAllah Azza wa Jal. That's Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلِذَلِكَ عُلَمَا they say, if for some reason Allah put you in charge in public affairs, office, a counselor, whatever, manager, whatever, if you are in charge of public office, subhanAllah, where whatever you have supposed to be given to the people, there's no reason for you to delay, to give it away, and there's no reason for you to be preserving some of them or reserving some of them for some other people. No. It is for them, you have to give it to them. Unlike what is happening today in the world, subhanAllah, between al-Mashriq wa al-Maghrib, someone will be put in charge in public affairs and he's supposed to give away this to the right people, it's not going to happen. 50% belongs to him, 25% belongs to his friends or colleagues, the 25% comes to those who are in need and they struggle, subhanAllah, they struggle and sometimes the stampede and the queue kills them. That's subhanAllah, unfortunate subhanAllah. If you're in public office, Allah make you in charge, you give it away whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it to you for these people, subhanAllah. That's what the ulama say in this hadith. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, وَمَنْ يَسْتَعْفِفْ SubhanAllah Whoever abstains from asking people despite being in need. Look at that. Whoever abstains from asking people despite being in need. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يُعِفُّهُ اللَّهُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him and will put his hand in content to subhanAllah. Content, satisfaction. SubhanAllah. Al-qina. Allah will make him qina subhanAllah. He might not have 3 meals a day. He might not have a spare car. He might not even drive. He's still in need. But for the sake of Allah, who yastahfif, subhanAllah. La yas'aluna an-nasa ilhafan. It was an ayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are masakeen people. And they are so amazing and so smart. You cannot even see their image and faces that they are poor. But they are poor. La yas'aluna an-nasa ilhafan. They don't beg people by hand. Never. They don't even ask you. Even if they need it, subhanAllah. That is one of the categories when Allah mentioned in many ayat, when it comes to the giving your mal to the masakin. The masakin in the Quran is being talked about are those ones. Nos alladhina yatakaffafuna an-nasa, subhanAllah, it's not those who are begging people by hand from one door to another door. Those are called as-sa'ilin. Wa amma as-sa'ila fala tanhar. Those who are going from one door to another is called as-sa'ilin. They ask people. Wa amma as-sa'ila fala tanhar. Those who ask, the ayah that we read now, those who ask and beg, do not chase them away. It's an ayah of Allah. But the masakin that Allah mentioned in many places, إِنَّ مَسَّدَقَاتُ لِلْفُقَرَاءِ وَالْمَسَاكِينَ are those ones. SubhanAllah. لَا يَسْأَلُونَ النَّاسِ الْحَافَ. They have 1 meal a day. The next meal is missed, is skipped. They don't have it. They don't have enough clothes. They don't have enough whatever. They have a difficulty in child fee, whatever. Those are the people, alhamdulillah, they don't show. But wallahi al-azim, they have an amazing khair if you spend in them, SubhanAllah. More than anything else, Allah will reward you so huge and so great. Then, whoever is still in need, and abstain is asking the people, يُعِفُّهُ اللَّهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put himself and his heart a contentment, subhanAllah. Satisfaction, subhanAllah, azza wa jal. In the Qutbah al-Maliyah in Jum'ah, we mentioned that, أَشَّرَفُ الْمُؤْمِنُ وَعِزَّتُهُ قِيَامُهُ بِاللَّيْلِ وَإِسْتِغْنَاؤُهُ عَنِ النَّاسِ. The sharaf, the honor and the dignity of the person as a mu'min depends قِيَامُهُ فِي اللَّيْلِ فِي النَّفَلْ تَهَجُّدْ وَإِسْتِغْنَاؤُهُ عَنِ النَّاسِ. And he doesn't ask people anything, subhanAllah, azza wa jal, even though he's in need. Then salawatullahi wa salam alayhi says, whoever does that and abstains people despite he's been in need, يُعِفُّهُ اللَّهُ. Allah will give him uncontentment, subhanAllah, azza wa jal. وَمَنْ يَسْتَغْنِي يُغْنِهُ اللَّهُ, subhanAllah, azza wa jal. And whoever shows self-sufficient, close to the same meaning, self-sufficient, despite being in need also, self-sufficient, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah said, يُقْنِهُ اللَّهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him qina, subhanallah, azza wa jalla. Allah will make him a self-sufficient. Look at that. Whatever you determine, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fi hadith al-Qudsi, he says, أَنَا عِنْدَ ذَنَّ عَبْدِي. I am will be what my servant thinks of me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, فَمَا ذَنُّكُمْ بِرَبِّكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, what are you thinking of Allah? Then if you have enough iman, whatever khair you think Allah could give you on the table, on the spot, but you do not have enough yaqeen in you, that's why you don't have anything. Wallahi lawla kana indana yaqeenan wa thiqqatan billah. If you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you whatever you want, everything would have come to your door, subhanallah azza wa jalla, yaqeenan. So that's what we need. And this place, it's a place to build it. One day, one time, come to the Sama, listen to this. This is how you build it, subhanAllah. This is the place to build that yaqeen. But if you are not in this place, how are you going to build it, yaqeen? You're not going to have yaqeen in your life. Then, that's what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he continued, he said, وَمَنْ يَتَسَبَّرْ subhanAllah. Whoever shows a patient at sabr, subhanAllah. As you know, the world is so flip-flop, subhanAllah. Hazzal and bazzal, subhanAllah. The world is a place of test, subhanAllah, azza wa jal. No matter even if you have something, you're still short of something. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا وَعَوْ بِنِ آدَمْ إِلَّا تُرَاب. Nothing will fill up the belly of Bani Adam except a turab, which is the sand. The ulama say, it means that he will only be satisfied and will be okay by the time they put his body on the ground. And that's when he died. Before that, everyone has a great ambition. Everyone has a great demand. Everyone has something. Even if he has 100, he needs another 100, subhanAllah, azza wa jal. Rasulullah, he said, if one mountain of dhahab will be given a Bani Adam, labtaqa wadiyani, he would have wanted another valley of gold to be given. That's what it is. It's an insan. It's a dabi'atul insan. Then whoever shows a sabr, subhanAllah. And keep in mind that all this description Rasulullah is given has to be for the sake of Allah. Istighfar lillah, wa istighna lillah, wa sabr lillah. If these things become for the sake of Allah, that is when all the good results will come out, subhanAllah. Not because I shy from so and so, no. It is from Allah, subhanAllah, azza wa jalla. And whoever makes sabr Despite being in need and having situation that way, he needs a people's help. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah, he said, يُسَبِّرُهُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ. Allah will give him a sabr, سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him a sabr in his heart, in his qalb. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fill up sabr in him, سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. I mentioned one time, this week, when one أحد السالحين, he said, I had a migraine for 20 years. None of my family and my wife even know about that. He does mention, he has migraine, so painful. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you and I and everyone else. He said, I lost my eyesight. Sometimes you can lose your eyesight while your eye is typically open without anyone. And even people cannot even realize that you're blind. Isn't it? There's so many people that are blind, but their eyes are, you and I, but the sight is gone. He said, I lost my eyesight and I never mentioned to my family. And that was almost 10 years or 8 years or whatever years ago. As-sabr wal-istighna, khalas. He accepted the decision and the judgment of Allah and that's gone. He's happy, subhanAllah Azza wa Jalla. However, it does not mean that you can ask your brother something. Of course you can. It's mubah, it's halal. It is. But the hadith is telling you what's khair, subhanAllah. Always, the deen is to raise your connection with Allah. Whatever is connection with the human or the khala'iq comes after that. Always, the deen of Allah stresses you to be connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any barrier at all, subhanAllah. Anything else will come by automatically by itself as a result of that, subhanAllah azza wa jalla. Salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, he continued and he said, وَمَا أُعْتِيَ أَحَدٌ. Nobody has been given عَطَاءً خَيْرًا, anything more blessing, more better and more greater, وَأَوْسَعَ, more verse and more wide and more big than sabr, subhanAllah. Than sabr. Nothing is more greater than a sabr, subhanAllah. If Allah gives the servant a sabr, subhanAllah, almost a half of his deen has been covered. Why? Why this thing has become half of your deen, subhanAllah, Azza wa Jalla? تحتاج السبر بالعبادة. You need to be patient with ibadah. You need a sabr عن المعاصي. You need to be patient from the ma'asi and isyan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You need to be sabr عند الفتن وعند الابتلاء والمش... all that. حياتك كلها تدور السبر. Everything needs a sabr. If you have connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, عز وجل. Even your family, your own child. The one you wake up every morning for fajr and he doesn't wake up, يحتاج sabr لديك subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to make sabr because of him. Make dua for him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your wife subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're going to the masjid, phone call is ringing, subhanAllah. The nabis and the milk are gone. تحتاج صبر, subhanAllah. You need to be صبر. يحول بينك وبين العبادة, subhanAllah, عز وجل. Your job, subhanAllah. You beg your supervisor, 1 hour for Jum'ah. He tells you, no, only half an hour. Otherwise you get fired. تحتاج صبر, subhanAllah. Coming with the conclusion, say, look boss, it's a Friday, I can't do that. Take my time off, my BTO, give me 90 minutes. تحتاج صبر سبحان الله ويقينا. Nothing will come without صبر سبحان الله عز وجل. If there was no صبر at all, many people, والله أصبحوا هالكين سبحان الله عز وجل. And this صبر is a gift from Allah سبحان الله عز وجل. And He gives whomever Allah سبحانه وتعالى wanted سبحان الله عز وجل. The علماء described the صبر in so many ways سبحان الله عز وجل. والصابرين في البأساء والضراء سبحان الله وحين البأس. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them many a times. And there's three things that Rasulullah mentioned and the hadith mentioned and the ulama mentioned. There's no reward, only Allah can reward you that, subhanAllah. Only Allah can reward you. Anything else, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned how much you get and how much reward is going to be, 10, 20, 700, whatever. الصبر سبحان الله عز وجل. الله سبحانه وتعالى in mention in the Quran, فأجره على الله. فأجره على الله. Whoever makes صبر, his reward will come directly from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And the person that's keeping a first or making a siyam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised and He said, الصوم لي وأنا أجزي. The sown is mine, I will reward you for that, subhanAllah azza wa jalla.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made these things obligation upon himself without anybody else dictating to him, subhanallah. It is sabr, one of them, subhanallah, azza wa jalla. Bi-idhnillah ta'ala, our dars will be this, and I will be repeating the hadith one more time, inshallah ta'ala, so and I can give the rest of them, inshallah ta'ala, the people to interact with the jama'ah, inshallah ta'ala, an Abi Sa'id al-Qudri, radiyallahu anhu, anna nasan min al-ansari sa'alu Rasulullah, a people from Ansar, they ask Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-wealth, fa'a'ta'ahum, thumma sa'aluhu fa'a'ta'ahum, they keep on asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah, he keep on giving them whatever he has, hatta nafidha ma indahu, until whatever he has in his sword has finished. And after that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ma yakuna indi min khayrin falan addaqiru ankum, whatever is in my possession, I will not be reserved, I will not keep it away from you, I will give it to you, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam promised. Walakin, wa man yasta'fif yu'iffuhu Allah, whoever abstains asking from the people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fill his heart with content. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him satisfied by man yasta'fif yu'iffuhu Allah.
Okay,
I'll take it. Man yastaghni, whoever shows the self-sufficient, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised, يُقْنِهُ اللَّهُ وَمَنْ يَتَصَبَّرْ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى says يُسَبِّرُ اللَّهُ وَمَا أُعْتِيَ أَحَدٌ no one has been given anything much better and much خير and much wider and faster and much worse than من الصبر أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وجزاكم الله خيرا في حضوركم وأحسن إليكم إن شاء الله تعالى السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته until our next حلقة إن شاء الله تعالى we have a جماعة in the masjid إن شاء الله تعالى the best that you can do right now it is to interact with them wallahi they might tell you a word that can transform your life إن شاء الله تعالى young and old إن شاء الله it is the sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم when I visit a chemistry to honor them and one of the honor it's not to give them food it is to be with them subhanallah عز وجل it is to be with them sit with them listen from them You know, talk to each other, subhanallah, azza wa jalla. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them a great reward, subhanallah, for coming. Because just to see us, that itself is an ajr azim, inshallah ta'ala. Jazakumullahu khair, inshallah ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.